All eyes are on this US election in the next 24 hours, and it's not just domestically, internationally, there's a fair bit to talk through. So let's do it right now. CSIS Chair Charles Edel joins us now. Charles, great to see you in person. We were talking before, just briefly, about the ramifications for this election. It's not really part of the election process here in terms of strategies and policies, but the ramifications come afterwards, right?
Yeah, no, in the US, like in Australia, foreign policy, national security is not generally at the top of voters' agenda, but it does factor in, and the implications of this are quite vast because the two candidates have very, very widely differentiated positions on a whole host of topics.
So let's talk about Donald Trump first.
Yeah.
This morning he was in North Carolina. You know, the border is a huge issue. Immigration is a huge issue. He wants the border shut again, and he's not afraid to use tariffs against Mexico. He was talking about 25% tariffs on anything coming into the country, a big trading partner. So he doesn't mind using that kind of thing to negotiate on the world stage. Get used to that.
Get used to that. I mean, if nothing, we know that Donald Trump loves tariffs. He's referred to himself as the tariff man. You said 25%.
Yeah.
But he said everywhere between 20 and 60% if your name rhymes with China. So I think this is going to be a consistent feature of how he sees his toolkit when he looks at foreign
policy.
America's
not going to care about that, but the rest of the world might. What about?
Well,
actually,
I'm not sure I agree with you, because it depends how those tariffs bounce back on the American people. Mm. If they're a beautiful tariff, as Trump says, that have no implications other than onshoring business for the Americans, Americans don't care. If countries and allies like Australia begin to go a tit for tat because there are tariffs aimed at allies and consumer prices go up, it matters.
There's a fair bit of bluster in him, though, isn't there?
It's hard to say what is real and what is not and where he might end up on any given day.
All right, Kamala Harris, is it more of the same internationally when we've seen what she's done and hasn't done?
Yeah, no, for Harris, especially given the way that the campaign played out, how she became the candidate, she has embraced the Biden administration's agenda full on, particularly keying on putting allies and partners at the center of everything. So she says she wants to take that agenda further. We haven't heard too much differentiation between her and Biden, which would obviously play out if she did become president. But I think we can expect much more on the allies and partners front.
Being conciliatory on that level doesn't necessarily bring about an end of wars, though.
Well, the question is, you can always get to an end of war if you decide to stop contesting it. And we know that Donald Trump has said that he'll end the war on day one. Well, the Ukrainian people get a vote here, too, as do their leaders. So the question is, are we negotiating from a position of strength or one where Russia has pole position?
Might be sticky, that the Ukrainian aspect of
indeed.
It. Who's going to win, just really quickly?
I have no opinion on that.
Come on. Think tank people.
Carl, it's more than think tank people. We have seven marginal states. They're all within the margin of error at this point. It's hard
close.
To say.
All right. I'll get you to say something off air. All right. Thank you so much. That's all unfolding in the next 24 hours. Yes.
Well, the US election is just hours away. A new president to be elected in one of the tightest races to the White House we have ever seen. If Donald Trump succeeds, the Australian government could be in damage control, facing calls to sack Ambassador to the US, Kevin Rudd. Joining us to discuss today's headlines is Tasmanian Senator Jackie Lambie and National Senator Bridget McKenzie, both in Canberra. Good to see you both. Jackie, Kevin Rudd was quick to make enemies in the Trump camp, labelling him the most destructive president in history. Does he survive if Trump wins?
Well, first of all, I don't think Trump's going to win. That would be my prediction. Secondly, because he's completely unhinged. And it really bothers me what's going to go on with the economy right around the world. I mean, he's flying tariffs everywhere. That doesn't show you how unhinged this bloke is. I don't know what does. And quite frankly, moving an ambassador that's going to bend down and kiss the rear end of Trump is not the answer either. So I don't understand that. He's got plenty of other friends over there, Rudd, that he's made. And just because he's not, you know, because he's not bending over to Trump and he's holding him accountable, I don't know what the problem is here. But quite frankly, that's the job I would have thought would have an ambassador doing. But you are not there as an ambassador. You are there to represent Australia. And quite frankly, you are not there to kiss their rear end. You are there to get your point across and get the job done. And as long as Rudd is getting the job done, I don't see what the problem is.
I guess the issue becomes, if Trump does win, whether Rudd can get the job done, given the frosty relationship that might become. Bridget, is Kevin Rudd the right man for the job?
Well, let's see what happens as an outcome of, you know, Americans going to the polls. The world is on the edge of its seat as we see, you know, Trump with some of those iconic moments, the assassination attempts, the serving burgers from the servery of McDonald's, and we've got Harris with things not really seen in a US election, femininity, word salads and joy. At the end of the day, our relationship with our closest ally will be maintained no matter who Americans pick. And Ambassador Rudd is a professional, and indeed I am confident will put our national interest first in dealing with whoever becomes the president post tomorrow.
Yeah, look, it's not just America that's anxious about what's going to happen in the next 24 hours, but I think it's fair to say the world will be watching incredibly closely the outcome in a shade over 24 hours. There's a lot going on in the world. For us, AUKUS may come into question, but there are more significant things like the two wars in the Middle East and Ukraine and Russia to talk about. So US Ambassador, the former US Ambassador to Yemen, Gerald Feierstein, joins me now. Gerald, thank you so much for your time. Really appreciate it. Donald Trump says he'll sort those two things out in a couple of days. What do you think?
It's a pleasure to be with you. I think we can assume that that's hyperbole. These are enormously complicated issues, and they're not open for resolution anytime in the, unfortunately, probably in the foreseeable future. I don't know, but certainly not in a few days.
Yeah, I think you're 100% right about that. Look, Kamala Harris has been campaigning in Michigan, really interesting battleground state that, especially with the Muslim population. And she's come under fire there, a fair bit of fire for her administration, not ending the war in the Middle East sooner or doing more, at least the perception of that anyway. How significant an issue do you think that is going to be for whoever takes administration?
Well, of course, in terms of the election, you're absolutely right, and it's particularly important in the state of Michigan, which is a battleground state and also has the largest Arab American community of any of the states of the U.S. So conceivably, it could be a determining factor in whether Trump or Harris wins the election. Beyond that, of course, once we get in, and assuming that there's not going to be a breakthrough anytime in the next 3 months, this is going to fall into the laps of the next administration. They're going to have to figure out how to move forward. And I think that there are a number of different issues. One, of course, is how to stabilize the region and reduce the tensions that are there, how to bring an end to the fighting in Gaza and in southern Lebanon, how to restore some kind of equilibrium between Israel and Iran so that we don't risk the a larger regional war that could come out of that. And then from there, how to move on for some of the critical issues that are going to confront the next administration, what to do in Gaza, how to do reconstruction, restoration for the population there that's been so severely damaged, devastated over this past year, and whether we can find a permanent resolution of the Israel-Palestine conflict that would bring an end to this cycle of violence that we've seen for really the last 75 years.
Just really quickly before we go, because we are running out of time, but Donald Trump, I would be at pains to point out there were no wars while he was president. Does he carry more of a stick internationally? Are people more fearful of him?
Well, I think that the biggest issue with Trump is that he's unpredictable, that one never knows. He runs a very transactional approach to issues. He may be your friend one day and your foe the next, or vice versa. And so it's not a question of being fearful of him, more than a question of not really knowing where you stand with him and what he's going to do on the next day. So. Obviously Kamala Harris is a much more reliable and knowable individual, and will presumably run an administration that is more predictable.
Even if there isn't the perception that there is much action. Good on you. We appreciate your time. Thank you so much, and best of luck over the next 24 hours.